calories. Oh, look. Oh god, the fish gods are...
Over here, it looks like it could go up to my chest. You in?
I don't want to do it. I'm too scared. You go.
Wait, I'll go. Oh man, found some fresh water here in Mexico. You guys remember one of my past videos? I did this in the salt water. Discovered a saltwater stingray. Oh boy, I already see some fish. We're gonna have to get in here real quick. Oh man, I see a bunch of cichlids, a bunch of different types. Okay, so I mentioned to you guys, and especially was posting on Instagram where I am. Whenever I travel somewhere, I never really say where I'm gonna be. I just end up going, and then I post where I'm gonna be, and I get flooded by locals wherever I'm at. And one of them, Sam, actually sent me a Google satellite image of the area that he thinks I'm in, circled it on the map and said, go look at this place. It's awesome. Lots of fish there. Sam, I'm here. And I'm gonna show everybody else what I discover and find in this water. Oh man, the water's probably gonna be warm. Look at the size of these guys. They almost look like Mayan cichlids of some sort. There is a bunch of smaller fish and larger fish out there. Yeah, so this, once again, guys, when we're setting up an aquarium, we often think like it's gotta be absolutely pristine and clean. All I'm stepping on is like probably 6 inches of debris. My foot just disappears in this stuff. Hopefully I don't catch anything. Oh, what a gorgeous setting. You know, this really, truly is absolutely stunning. But if I go in too deep there, I'm not gonna be able to see anything. So I'm probably gonna have to stay quite a ways back to be able to do this and get any shots of the fish. Look at them all. These guys are huge. All right, look, I'm already mucking the water up. I'll put you in so you can see. Watch my foot disappear. Oh, I found a rock to stand on. You guys can see what's going on down here. They're jumping. See them all right here? All right, maybe we can get onto that rock over there. Whew, it's cold. There they are. The water's just crystal clear until I step through it, but watch this. Water is nice enough to swim in, but it's so dirty that I don't think anybody actually ever gets in it or does anything of the like. It's just too shallow, you know, knee deep, ankle deep, and I just don't think anybody's swimming in it. But we've got 3 different types of fish in here. Some sort of big cichlid. I am not sure what that is, to be honest with you. And then we have some smaller guppies, I think. And maybe those are platies over here. I would love to get closer and closer, but I just don't want to scare them too much. Let's see if I could bring them over. Yeah, there's 2 different types of species of cichlid in here. Oh wow, watch this. Did bring a little bit of bread just to entice the fish over a little bit more. They are skittish, they don't want to be around me. We're gonna dive in here deeper here in a second, but feeding fish to your pond fish or aquarium, or feeding bread, I'm sorry, is one of the worst things you could possibly give them. Causes so many issues, but when it comes to wild fish, of course it's not good for them, it's just empty calories. Oh god, the fish gods are saying, stop giving them bread.
it is not good to give them, but at the same time, these are wild fish and they're not getting this quite very often at all. What's nipping me? Yeah, these tiny little fish in here, there's so many of them. See them there? All right, let's keep going. I want to get out deeper. Look at this though. Everybody's like trying to create these nature aquariums, and when you really get out into nature, you can truly see that it's mostly just mud and rocks and a few fallen over sticks. And I've been trying to explain this, but people are like, no, it looks so dirty. You need to have it cleaner and more pristine, and you know, and people talking rule of thirds. And where is the rule of thirds here? Where is that here in actual nature? It's like something's in the woods over there. He's rattling around, probably one of them weird raccoon things. All right, let's go back in. I can't identify these guys from the top, and I didn't bring my mask, so I can't get in to actually see them. What did you find? It's an iguana back there, and a girl in a bathing suit. What did you find? All right, there's hundreds and hundreds of fish in here. This is absolutely awesome. It's the big guys going at the bread, though. I don't want to give them a lot. I got one slice of bread I'm trying to make last. I'm not going to sit here and feed them a loaf, but an entire ecosystem balance, big fish, little fish. Look at these little guys over here, there's hundreds. Absolutely in love with this little hole in the water here. I mean, it just goes to show when you're setting up your aquarium and you're trying to make it look absolutely gorgeous. When you actually look in the wild in a spot like this, it's rocks, detritus, algae, leaf litter, and a few sticks. And that's mostly what we're seeing in this location, of course. But I guess what I'm trying to stress here is don't overthink your aquariums. If your fish are looking happy and displaying color wonderfully, you probably hit the scape right on the nose for them. Oh, they are beautiful. We have one over here under this rock. I'm gonna show you. It looks like he's in breeding dress, so maybe we'll see one with a bunch of fry. This is a different species of cichlid. Definitely a cichlid. I can't tell what it is. Almost looks like it has Jack Dempsey coloration, but I don't think they're gonna be in this location in Mexico. But wow, these guys are gorgeous. Come look. Get in there. So I'm definitely seeing two species of cichlid and some sort of a live bearer and maybe a tetra back there. What do you guys see? There's so much glare for me, it's hard for me to see anything. So you guys are actually getting a better look and enjoying this much more than I am. All I'm enjoying is my feet being sunk into all of the soil or whatever below me and fish nipping at my legs and kind of chilly. And you guys are seeing the best. Look at this. Imagine if this was your aquarium. Look, I'm gonna go under, but it's just two sticks and that's it. And the fish are loving it.
got is this little ball of mush that I'm feeding them and you know, flicking off a little part here and there. It's not like I have a bunch of this, so I want to be careful. I'm slipping and sliding everywhere. I wonder what's, if I can get anywhere else in here. The bigger guys are all in the deeper spots, but it looks like the shaded areas might have some more fish. It looks like the deeper areas is, of course, the bigger fish, and then over in the shallower spots are the smaller fish. And this is something what you probably come to expect anyways. The deeper you go, the bigger the fish become. Don't bite me. Whoever bit me needs to stop. No snacks. Oh, I love this rock formation. Watch this. This rock formation is beautiful. Right here. Imagine this in your gram. Watch. Yeah, they're just three rocks. Stop overthinking your scapes and going nuts with all these plants and crazy stuff that you fish probably don't need and will probably eat. A planted aquarium, of course, is beautiful, but what you see in the wild versus what we see in the aquariums are stuck. Oh, differences. I'm falling.
Capture on choking. Make sure you get on camera, Joey. You're a YouTuber.
I could just sit here for hours. I know you guys could too. I would spend probably 3 to 4 hours walking through this slowly, but I just have a few minutes. I gotta get back to everybody else and make sure they don't think that Joey's only here for the fish. Second. Hey, do you want to get in? Okay. You should get in. Just put all that stuff down.
All right, we'll see what it's like for a girl to be in here
getting nipped. I don't think she can hear me, that the fish are all biting at me and stuff, but it'll be funny if a girl, not to say girls can't do this, but it's not what you think. What?
Anywhere you want.
It's only up to your waist at most, maybe. Over here, it looks like it could go up to my chest. You in? Yeah, so I just take this and do a little bit of... I want to be in the water. I think that, oh, the right here looks like a jump off spot.
Yeah. I feel like people might jump off.
Do you think so?
Like,
oh man.
I'll jump off if you jump off. You guys dare me to jump off?
Oh man. It looks deep. I guess I could jump off. I guess it's not that big of a deal. What do you think?
Oh man. It looks deep.
I guess the only way to swim with the fish is to jump in and swim with the fish.
I'm gonna go, you gonna come?
Let me know how deep it is.
It's gonna be deep. It looks real deep.
Our stuff's just right over there. I want some little iguana or something to go taking it on me. Oh boy, I'm gonna need a shower after this, it looks like. I don't wanna do it, I'm too scared. You go.
What?
Wait, I'll go. I don't know what you're doing.
Touched the bottom, but then I sunk into the bottom more.
I don't know what's in there. It like grabbed me. It started to bring me in. Oh man, this was incredible. Shout out to the guy who recommended this spot, but I gotta get out of here. I already feel pretty grimy. I'm gonna save this for another day. It's weird because whatever I jumped into didn't stir the water. I'm still a little clear over there. There was no fish over there either. There was just a clear, it looks like it's a jump off spot. Maybe people do come here to swim. Yeah, so you can see where I kind of mucked it up a little bit. That's fine, that's gonna release all kinds of food for them as well. One slice of bread isn't gonna hurt anybody either. I doubt anybody comes back here. Wow, I wonder if thousands of years ago, if this existed, or even 1,000 years ago, or even a little bit more, a little bit less, when the Mayans were kind of roaming these areas, did they see this as well, or is this, this definitely can't be man-made, there's like a cave over there, but did they experience this as well? Were these species of fish here looking the same? Oh, it's just so incredible. Love it, love it, love it. Wherever you go, wherever you are, this is inspiring me to go back to Nova Scotia, where I'm from, and get in the water in the summer, not right now, and see what there is. And I hope that is for you as well. And perhaps maybe you can kind of sort of apply this to your aquarium at home, or something you see, or something that has inspired you. This is pothos. You guys, for years and years and years and like, what, I don't know how many years, another little lizard thing. I've advocated taking a clipping of this and tossing it in your tank, just the roots. And those roots are gonna grow and grow and grow. But anyways, they're gonna remove the nitrates from your aquarium and basically eradicate algae issues if you have any. What's that? I don't think so. I think that one's just way too big to be one. It's the same colors, but yeah, no, this isn't. This one's way too big. I don't know what that is, but it's similar. This is definitely the common houseplant pothos. You know, next time you see this at your grandma's or something, just take a little snippet off. Make sure there's like three or four leaves on it. For example, like something like around this. Just put the root in it, or the base of it in the water, and it's gonna sprout a bunch of roots, and it's going to suck the nitrates out of your tank like you wouldn't believe. I wonder if this is what happens in the wild, how big it actually gets. Because maybe, yeah, that is pothos. I think you were right. I think that is pothos, because you can look at it starting here. Man, it's all over the place. Look at this. Starts all the way over there. Climbs up the tree. Oh, this is incredible, guys. I've been using this stuff in my aquariums and for years, and I've made videos about it. The simplicity surrounding it, just taking a slice. Maybe I'll start doing that again. I know that it started to take off and lots of YouTubers start to use it, but isn't that something? I don't know what I'm more excited about, the actual fish and, you know, types of fish we see in our home aquariums. There's someone. Or am I more excited about this pothos, seeing it in the wild, you know, for the first time? I don't know. Let me know what you guys liked about this video in the comment section below. And if you can identify this, I'll be able to identify them once I get into editing and I'm not standing looking over. Look at this. Yeah, so some of this looks to be man-made. But as soon as I'm not editing any... Whoa! The pothos is everywhere. Watch this. And then it gets bigger and bigger and then huge. I gotta do this at home somehow. This is just absolutely incredible. Wow. It's so something so simple probably to the locals, but absolutely captivating to me. Anyways, I'll probably be able to identify all these fish once I get to editing, but seeing the glare from the top of the water, not being able to see the fish properly, is making it tough. But I think I'm pretty close. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Now that we're back, I've had a little bit of time to think about what I just did, and I can't help but feel overwhelmed with guilt knowing that I just trotted through their home, you know, and especially the jumping in part. I probably won't do that again, but I can only imagine what it's like and what it feels like to have this big hairless giant gorilla pig jumping into your home and making a splash at a huge mess. We all know what that's like. But yeah, I think moving, you know, I was just too excited. I had to go get in the water. I had to look. And I'll never have that opportunity again, and I know it. But yeah, if you're ever doing this and, you know, taking inspiration from this, just try to disturb as little as possible, and obviously the fish are gonna be okay.